They need to allow persecution or their problems to hinder them. And it's still the same Bible, the same gospel. It's still the same Jesus that comes in our heart. It's still the same Holy Ghost he gives unto us. It is still the same heaven we're going. We must have the same zeal like they had. If they were able to do it, we are going to do it too. I said we're going to do it too. The experience and the Lord gave them conviction. I experience you'll give us conviction. The experience and the Lord gave them courage. I experience you'll give us courage. The experience and the Lord gave them consecration. They laid everything on the altar and they said, this gospel, we're going to publish it. And they published it. And the word of God was blessed in their mouth. I come to point number three now. Glorious pattern for global penetration. Glorious pattern for global penetration. When we talk about pattern, that means an example. That means a model. Something for you to follow. As I talk about the glorious pattern, there are three things here. Number one, the pattern for overseers and missionaries. You find that in this chapter. There is a pattern here. If we say, well, I've been sent out, an apostle is sent out. If we say I've been sent, a missionary is sent out. If we say I'm sent, I'm not just over a local church alone. I'm over a number of churches. That's like an apostle. That's like an overseer. A state overseer, a national overseer, a region overseer. There is a pattern for us here. Now, there are pastors who are just on one church. There are evangelists who are just in a locality, in a location. There's a pattern here for pastors and evangelists. And then number three, there are members of the church, individuals. And here we have a pattern. Pattern for us too. Let's see the pattern for overseers and missionaries. Let's look at chapter 8, verse 25. Chapter 8, verse 25. And they, when they had testified, preached the word of the Lord and returned to Jerusalem and preached the gospel in many villages of the Samaritans. They didn't just remain in one place. They preached the gospel everywhere. It says that when these people, the pattern we're talking about now for the overseers, the pattern we're talking about now for all these missionaries, they preached the word in the villages of the Samaritans. As we look at the word of God, we're looking at Luke chapter 4. In Luke chapter 4, you see this pattern as well, that the Lord gave them what he did and what we're supposed to do as well. In Luke chapter 4, I'm reading here from verse 42. It says, when it was day, he departed and went into a desert place, and the people sought him and came unto him, and they stayed him. That is, they stopped him, saying that he should not depart from them. And he said unto them, I must preach the kingdom of God to other cities also, for therefore am I sent. You see that pattern, you see that model, you see that example, that Jesus did not just stay in one place. He was a model, he was an example, a pattern for you and for me, those of us who are missionaries and those of us who are pastors and overseers. Look at that verse 43 again. He said unto them, I must preach the kingdom of God to other cities also, for therefore am I sent. In verse 44, and he preached in the synagogues of Galilee. He preached, and we're going to do it. I said we're going to do it. How about the pattern for pastors and evangelists? We're looking at Acts of the Apostles chapter 8. Acts of the Apostles chapter 8. And I'm reading from verse 5. Then Philip went down to the city of Samaria and preached Christ unto them. Philip and evangelists, that's the model he has set for us. We don't just stay in one place and just abide there. I'm there Sunday, I'm there Monday, I'm there Thursday. I'm just in that one place. But we go on to other places and we preach the gospel in those other places. Is a pattern has been set for us, a model has been given to us, an example has been given unto us. Then Philip went down to the city of Samaria and preached Christ unto them. Look at verse 14 of that Acts of the Apostles chapter 8. Acts of the Apostles chapter 8 verse 14. Then Philip was found at Azotus, and passing through, he preached in all the cities. Evangelists, he preached in all the cities. Pastors, he preached in all the cities. Overseers, he preached in all the cities to the king. Came to Caesarea. And now we're seeing the example, the pattern, the model for missionaries and for overseers. We've seen the pattern for pastors and evangelists. Now you see the pattern for members. Let's look at Acts of the Apostles chapter 8 and verse 4. Acts of the Apostles chapter 8 and verse 4. Therefore, they that were scattered abroad went everywhere preaching the word. You will do it. I said you will do it. And as we do it, it will be effective in Jesus' name. Look at Luke now. Luke chapter 9. I'm reading from verse 6. Luke chapter 9. We're looking at verse 6. And you see here what the Lord is telling us to do. He tells us in Luke chapter 9, verse 6. It says, they departed and went through the towns and preached the gospel, healing everywhere. Everywhere. That means in all the cities, in all the villages. We're not just to sit in one place and just relax. As if, you know, church is there. Ministry is there, work is there, but we're moving on to every place, and that's the pattern he has given us here. That's the example he has given us over there. Look at chapter 10. In chapter 10 of Luke, I'm reading from verse 1. Luke chapter 10, we're looking at verse 1. After these six, the Lord appointed other 70 also and sent them two and two before his face into every city and place whither he himself will come. He sent them to places. Isn't that what we, those of us who are district pastors and group pastors, ought to do? We get all those leaders together, those who can preach, those who can declare the word, and we say, you go that area, you go that in this. This is a period of dawn. That is a discipling a whole nation. And we group the people together. We assign them to the work they ought to do. That's what Jesus did. He called all these 70. Some people have 70 workers. They don't know what to do with them. Some people have 100 workers. They don't know what to do with them. And we're just in that local church all the time. But here Jesus Christ divided them two by two. They went everywhere. Look at verse 2. Therefore said he unto them, the harvest truly is great, but the laborers are few. Pray ye therefore the Lord of the harvest that he will send forth laborers into his harvest. Go your ways. Behold, I send you as lambs before wolves. And those people went, they succeeded, you will succeed. The work of God prospered in their hands. The work will prosper in your hand in Jesus' name. See in verse 17, and the 70 returned again with joy, saying, Lord, even the devils are subject unto us through thy name. You go with the name of Jesus, the devils will be subject unto you. Evil spirits will come out and cry and come out in Jesus' name. And all those who are sick, as you lay your hands on them and pray for them, they will get well in Jesus' name. The 70 returned again with joy. You return with joy, saying, Lord, even the devils are subject unto us through thy name. And he said unto them, I beheld Satan as lightning fall from heaven. Behold, I give unto you power to tread on serpents and scorpions, and over all the power of the enemy. And tell me the rest, and nothing shall by any means hurt you. Notwithstanding in this, rejoice not that the spirits are subject unto you, but rather rejoice because your names are written in heaven. You see, these people, they were not even baptized in the Holy Ghost yet. They were just saved, their names written in the book of life in heaven, and yet they did the work. You will do the work. We're told in Matthew chapter 24. In Matthew chapter 24, I'm reading here from verse 12. Whatever the persecution, whatever the suffering, whatever the challenges, whatever the conflicts we are facing, the Lord is saying, he's giving us a work to do. And the work must be done, and the work must go on, not minding the persecution or the pressure or the pain or the suffering. In Matthew chapter 24, I'm reading from verse 12. Matthew chapter 24, reading from verse 12, and because iniquity shall abound, the love of many shall wax old. The cold. Then it says, but he that shall endure to the end, the same shall be saved. He that shall endure to the end. Where are the people that will endure to the end? You endure to the end in Jesus' name. But see this in verse 14 now, and this gospel of the kingdom shall be preached. Persecution, this gospel of the kingdom shall be preached. Suffering, this gospel of the kingdom shall be preached. Iniquity shall abound, and the love of many other people will wax cold. All the same, this gospel of the kingdom shall be preached in all the world for a witness unto all nations. And then it says, and then shall the end come. The Lord is telling us that this work is very important. Saving of souls and preaching the gospel and telling people they ought to come to the Lord Jesus Christ. And it is not a kind of work we leave only to the apostles and the pastors and the evangelists. Is something that is given to everyone, and every member of the church of the living God must be involved in this. Every brother, every sister, and you in particular, you'll be involved in Jesus' name. We're looking at Romans chapter 10. In Romans chapter 10, I read from verse 17. Romans chapter 10, verse 17 says, so then, faith cometh by hearing, and hearing by the word of God. So then, faith cometh by hearing, and hearing by the word of God. But I say, in verse 18, have they not heard? Yes, verily their sound went into all the earth, and their words unto the ends of the world. Do you see what has happened now? As we started from Acts of the Apostles, chapter 1, chapter 2, Jerusalem, and then we come to chapter 8, they were scattered abroad to Judea and Samaria. And now as we come over here to Romans chapter 10, verse 18, it says their word, their preaching, their sound, their message has now gone to the ends of the world. We are the people now, it's our turn. I said it's our turn. They did it faithfully at their own time. We are going to do it faithfully at our own time too, in Jesus' name. Now look at James chapter 4, verse 17. James chapter 4, we're looking at verse 17. James chapter 4, we're looking at verse 17 here. We know the truth and we know that this is our responsibility and this is what must be done. What are you doing about it? James chapter 4, verse 17. Therefore, to him that knoweth to do good and do doeth it not, tell me, to him it is sin. Therefore, to him that knoweth to do good and doeth it not, tell me out loud, to him it is sin. We're going to read everything together. Verse 17, 1, 2, 3, go. God bless you. Therefore, to him that knoweth to do good and doeth it not, to him it is sin. I pray that we'll not be idle. I pray we'll not fold our hands. He has given us the work to do. We're going to do it in Ezekiel chapter 3. Ezekiel chapter 3, and I'm reading here from verse 17. It says, son of man, you are the person the Lord is talking to. Daughter of man, you are the one the Lord is talking to. I have made you a watchman unto the house of Israel. Hear the word at my mouth. Therefore, hear the word at my mouth and give them warning from me. When I say to the wicked, thou shalt surely die, and thou givest him not warning, nor speaketh to warn the wicked from his wicked way, the same to save his life. The same wicked man shall die in his iniquity, but his blood will I require at your hand. You see, it's you will fight the word of God. It's not something you can just toss aside and throw away and say, well, it doesn't matter, other people are doing it. If I don't do it, it doesn't matter. We cannot say that. It's giving us the responsibility. We cannot say the apostles are doing it, the prophets and the preachers and the evangelists and the pastors and the teachers, they're doing it. I don't have to. You have to. He's giving you the responsibility. And he says, to him that knoweth to do good and doeth it not, to him it is sin. Look at verse 18. When I say unto the wicked, thou shalt surely die, and thou givest him not warning, nor speakest to warn the wicked from his wicked way to save his life, the same wicked man shall die in his iniquity, but his blood will I require at your hand. When you see a righteous person backsliding, a righteous person that is going astray, and say, well, I will not talk. If I talk, they will not understand. If I talk, they will not even answer me. They will not respond to me. He says, still do it. Do your part. And if you do your part, whether they listen or not, then that's in their hand. If you will do your part, the Lord will bless you for doing your part in Jesus' name. It says in verse 19, yet if thou warn the wicked, that he turn not from his wickedness, nor from his wicked way, he shall die in his iniquity, but thou hast delivered thy soul. Verse 20 again, when a righteous man does turn from his righteousness and commit iniquity, and I lay a stumbling block before him, he shall die because thou hast not given him warning. He shall die in his sin, and his righteousness which he has done shall not be remembered, but his blood will I require at thy hand. You know, we're there in the fellowship, we know each other. We're there in the zone, in the district, we know each other. And as we know each other, we minister to each other. If you see somebody going astray, you tell them that's going astray. If you see somebody who's not living right, you tell them to go back to the Lord. It says, if you don't do it, his blood will I require at your hand. Nevertheless, in verse 21, if thou warn the righteous man, that the righteous righteous sinneth, and he does not sin, thou and he shall surely live, because he's one, and also thou hast delivered thy soul. The Lord is telling us that we will obey, we shall obey him, and we're going to obey the Lord. I said we're going to obey the Lord. We have seen today in Acts of the Apostles chapter 8, and we have seen verse 4 in particular, we have seen that it is every member of the church, every believer in the Lord that is preaching the gospel, proclaiming the gospel, presenting the gospel to every creature around us. It says, therefore, they that were scattered abroad went everywhere preaching the word. That's what we are going to do. How many of us are going to do it? You'll do it in Jesus' name. Let's rise up now and talk to the Lord in prayer. They that were scattered abroad went everywhere, and they were preaching the word. They that were scattered abroad, they went everywhere preaching the word. The Lord wants us to do it, and he that knows to do good and does not do it, to him it is sin. The Lord has given us the word of salvation. He has given us the word of his grace. He has given us the word that will make people to repent and turn to the Lord completely. And he's saying, Go and tell them. Jesus died for sinful men. Yeah, he doesn't want us to die. He doesn't want to perish. He wants us to go and tell them. You make up your mind. Say, oh Lord, help me. Oh Lord, help me. I will obey. I will do your work. The Lord said, go ye into all the world and preach the gospel to every creature. Go ye into all the world. Preach the gospel to every creature. In your school, preach to them. In your place of work, preach to them. In your community, preach to them. In your house, preach to them. In your family, preach to them. The people you know, don't just talk about material things, and we're building, we're doing this, we're doing that. Don't just talk about money, we're getting salary, we're doing this. Don't just talk about mundane things, but talk about real salvation unto them. Go preach the gospel to every creature. Tell them to repent. Tell them to come to know the Lord. Tell them that sin will lead to spiritual death, and sin will lead to eternal death. But you tell them that they can come to the Lord Jesus Christ. Jesus is Savior. Jesus is Lord. Let them make Jesus their Savior. Let them make Jesus their Lord. And as they believe on the Lord Jesus Christ, they will be saved. Their names will be written in the book of life, and they will not perish. And the Lord will reward you. The Lord will reward you. This is not just the work for apostles and for pastors and teachers alone. It's for every member. It's for every member. It's for every member. You've seen it yourself. The Lord gave the word, and great was the company of the people that published it. You've seen it yourself. Therefore, they that were scattered abroad went everywhere preaching the word. Went everywhere preaching the word. Went everywhere preaching the word. The Lord is calling upon you. Do your part. Do your part. They went everywhere. They went everywhere. And as we're going everywhere, we're going to preach the word. As we move everywhere, we're going to preach the word. On our streets, mark out all the houses and knock on their doors and show them the way to life. Don't allow them to